Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in financial accounting. Over the next few minutes, I'm going to provide you with a high-level overview of the principal financial statements. We'll start off by answering the question to, what even are financial statements? Next, we'll get an understanding of who uses these financial statements and why they might be important to you. Finally, we'll dive into a brief overview of the income statement, balance sheet, and cash flow statement. Whether you're looking to be a manager in a business, start your own company, or even become an investor, a general understanding of financial statements will arm you with the tools you need to be successful. So what's the big deal with financial statements anyways? Well, accounting is the language of business. And just like any other language, we need a way to efficiently communicate information about a company's performance to stakeholders. When I first started looking at financial statements, all I saw was a bunch of numbers on a page. Maybe you feel the same way. But once I started to get a basic understanding of the purpose behind each statement, a light bulb went off and things started to come together. So let's clear up some of the confusion and give you an understanding of why financial statements exist and how they can be used to make crucial business decisions. Imagine you're a bank and a company comes knocking on your door looking to borrow a large sum of money. You likely wouldn't just hand them the cash, but instead would be looking to get an understanding of the business and make an assessment on whether the company has the ability to pay you back. Think to yourself what type of information you would want to consider before handing them over the loan. Probably things like the company's profitability, cash flows, and the collateral they have to cover their debts. It could take weeks to sift through a company's financial records. Now, this is where the financial statements come in to save the day. The majority of companies prepare standard financial statements following a set of accounting rules. This allows a variety of stakeholders, such as company management, creditors, investors, and even the government, to look under the hood of the company's operations and make important business decisions. So by this point, I know you're sitting on the edge of your seat waiting to hear more about the specific financial statements. Well, you're in luck. Let's run through a high-level overview of each financial statement, starting with the balance sheet. You can think of the balance sheet as a snapshot of a moment in time that gives us an overview of an organization's financial health, broken down into assets, liabilities, and owner's equity. Assets are the resources the organization owns, such as their cash, land, and equipment. Liabilities are the debts that the organization has taken on, such as things like bank loans, wages owed to employees, or debts that they owe to suppliers. The last category is owner's equity, which is the value that remains with the owners, including investment that comes into the company and the earnings generated over time. On the balance sheet, the value of the company's assets must always equal the value of the company's liability plus the owner's equity. This is where the term balance sheet comes from. The balance sheet must always remain in balance. And if something doesn't balance, it means we have a major problem on our hands. From looking at a company's balance sheet, we can quickly get an understanding of whether a company is struggling or thriving, in addition to determining the company's value to shareholders and investors. Now, the income statement is like a report card that gives us insight into a company's success over a period of time. In order to keep the lights on, a business must ultimately generate profit. And the income statement is where users can determine how profitable the company was in a particular month, quarter, or year. The income statement can be broken down into three key components and follows the formula revenue minus expenses equals net income, which is otherwise known as profit. The first section of the income statement keeps track of all the company's revenue, which is the amount earned for selling goods or services. Let's say I'm operating a food truck and sell a hamburger to you for $10. That's $10 of revenue in my pocket. If I were to sell 1,000 hamburgers in a month, that would be $10,000 of revenue. However, it's important to remember that revenue does not equal profit. In order to determine the profitability of a company, we need to take into account all of the operating expenses. In our food truck example, we would need to pay for things like the fuel and electricity to operate the truck, kitchen employees' hourly wages, and permit fees. Let's say these fees all work out to $5,000 in total cost for the month. The final step would be to take all the revenue earned for a period of time, less all the expenses, and hopefully we have something left over at the end of the day. if revenue is greater than expenses, like it is in this case, we have $5,000 of net income. If expenses are greater than revenue, we would have a net loss. Profit breathes life into an organization, and the income statement serves as a key tool to help organizations make profitable decisions. We all know that cash is king when it comes to operating a business. While the balance sheet tells us the actual amount of cash sitting in the company, it doesn't tell us exactly where the money came from and where it's being spent. This is where the cash flow statement works its magic by showing us the flow of every dollar, breaking it down into three sections: operating activities, investing activities, and financing activities. Why does this even matter? Well, if you were an investor in an organization, wouldn't it be nice to know how the company is bringing funds into that organization? This would be communicated in their financing activities. You would probably also want to know what the company is actually doing with your hard-earned money. Is it being invested in new inventory and equipment, or is it being used to pay management salaries and bonuses? This would fall under their investing activities on the cash flow statement. Understanding this statement can arm users with crucial information about a company's future performance. Now that we have a general understanding of the three principal financial statements, there's a couple of things we want to watch out for. Accuracy. We need to remember that financial statements are usually prepared by the company, which leaves the door open for management bias. Management may at times be motivated to make things look better than they are, which is where validation comes into play. Look for whether or not the financial statements have been audited by a reputable accounting firm. Certain companies, such as publicly traded organizations, are required to have their financial statements signed off by a third-party accounting firm. However, keep in mind that not all financial statements are audited. Time for a quick recap. Financial statements provide users with critical information about the company's performance. The balance sheet gives us a snapshot of the company's financial health and valuation. The income statement provides a report card of the company's ability to generate profit. And the cash flow statement lets us know specifically how the company is earning and spending their cash. Whether you're a business owner, employee, investor, or student, understanding how to read and make decisions from the information in these financial statements is a critical skill in today's business world. While we just skimmed the surface here in this video, if you're interested in learning more, please feel free to check out our additional videos on Chegg, where we dive deeper into each of these financial statements.